गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? फाइन, ओके, वेरी गुड स्टूडेंट्स. नाउ इज द सेशन ऑफ इकोनॉमिक्स एंड एज माइक्रो इकोनॉमिक्स इज गोइंग ऑन इन विच वी हैव कंप्लीटेड द टू first two chapters. They are very long chapters which we have completed till now. The first chapter is national income accounting and the next chapter is money and banking. Already we have done all this. Students, today I am going to start the new chapter of macroeconomics, and that is aggregate demand. Okay, before starting this chapter, let us first understand what is called aggregate demand. You know, students, when we say individual demand, then it refers to the demand of one commodity by an individual consumer. When we say market demand, then it refers to the demand by all consumers in the market for a commodity. But when we say aggregate demand, then it refers to the sum total of demand made by all sectors of the economy or all the people of an economy over a period of time for final goods and services at a given level of income and at a given price level. Or you can say aggregate demand in fact is the total demand for goods and services made by different people of the economy or different sectors of the economy. That is called aggregate demand. Okay. Now, how is this aggregate demand measured? This aggregate demand is measured in terms of the expenditures made by different people or different sectors on goods and services. That means whatever we spend on purchase of goods and services, that reflects our demand. The same way, if we want to measure the level of aggregate demand in an economy, then we should measure it in terms of the expenditures made by different sectors on different goods and services. Or you can say the aggregate demand in fact is the desired or planned expenditure on goods and services, or you can say ex ante expenditure on goods and services by different people or different sectors of the economy. That is called aggregate demand. Or aggregate demand can be expressed in terms of the total expenditures made by different people over a period of time on different goods and services. Okay, high expenditures reflect high level of aggregate demand and low expenditures reflect low level of aggregate demand. Okay, so when we say aggregate demand, it is in fact the planned expenditure or ex ante expenditure or the demand, the amount of goods and services which the people of an economy have planned to purchase at a given level of income and at a given price level. That is all about aggregate demand. Okay, you know, students, द इकोनॉमिक ग्रोथ एंड डेवलपमेंट ऑफ एन इकोनॉमी इनफैक्ट डिपेंड्स ऑन द लेवल ऑफ एग्रीगेट डिमांड. इनफैक्ट इट डिपेंड्स ऑन इफेक्टिव डिमांड, बट इफेक्टिव डिमांड इज ऑल्सो डिटरमिंड बेसिकली by the level of aggregate demand. So from this point of view, it is very important to understand the different components and behavior of aggregate demand. Okay, when we say aggregate demand, then it can be classified into the four components which are called household consumption demand, investment demand, government's demand, and net export demand. Okay, when we say household consumption demand, then it refers to the demand for final goods and services made by household consumers. Okay, and this demand in fact is for consumption purposes. The household consumers purchase goods and services for their final consumption. So household consumption demand for goods and services is a very important component of aggregate demand. Right? Now, what will be the level of household consumption demand in an economy? Primarily, it depends on the two factors which are called propensity to consume and the level of income respectively. When we say propensity to consume, then it refers to the eagerness, the willingness of the people to spend their income on consumption or on purchase of goods and services. Okay, and this propensity to consume of a person is measured in terms of the expenditure made by him or her on goods and services for consumption. So if a person is spending larger proportion of his income on goods and services, then it implies high propensity to consume. And if a consumer purchases, spends less proportion of his income on purchase of goods and services, then it implies low propensity to consume. Okay, obviously, if there is high propensity to consume, higher will be household consumption demand, and if there is lower propensity to consume, there will be lower level of household consumption demand. Okay, so it depends on the two factors primarily, household consumption demand. And it is expressed in terms of consumption function, which we shall discuss later on after completing this topic. Okay, you know, students, whatever expenditure is made by household consumers on goods and services over time is called private final consumption expenditure. That shows a very important or major component of aggregate demand. Okay. The second important component of aggregate demand is called investment demand. In fact, this demand refers to the demand for goods and services by producing sector or by different producing units to produce final goods and services. This demand of producers may include the demand for machineries, tools, equipments, buildings, lands, raw materials, labor, and so many other inputs which are required in production process. Okay. And the demand for this type of goods and services made by the producing sector is called investment demand, right? And this demand is also measured in terms of the expenditure made by producing sector on different goods and services to produce final goods and services. Okay. And it is called investment demand, which is very important requirement to promote high pace of economic growth. In fact, the high rate of economic growth of an economy depends on the rate of investment, and this investment demand made by producing sector basically depends on the two factors. First, it depends on marginal efficiency of investment or marginal efficiency of capital, called MEI or MEC. And second, it depends on rate of interest. Since we are studying the short-run equilibrium of an economy by Keynes, and Keynes has considered that the investment demand is made through borrowings in the short run. And borrowings made by different producing units are always at a given rate of interest. So, the rate of interest is a very important determinant of investment demand. When we say MEC or MEI, then it refers to the expected return from investment of an additional capital in the business, in the production. Okay. And investment demand basically depends on this MEI or MEC, the expected rate of return from additional investment. Okay. This investment demand will keep rising so long as the rate of return from additional investment, called MEI or MEC, is greater than the rate of interest. This is called investment demand. But if the rate of interest is higher than the MEI or MEC, then there will not be investment demand at all. So, students, basically there are two determinants of investment demand, and they are called the marginal efficiency of investment and the rate of interest. How is this investment demand measured? This investment demand is also measured in terms of the expenditure made by producing sector. And this expenditure in fact is called either investment expenditure or gross domestic capital formation. The third important component of aggregate demand is the government's demand. You know, students, When we say government, then it refers to the administrative setup of an economy. And to administer the economy and to provide civic services like road constructions, health facilities, educational facilities, drinking water, and many more arrangements are made by the government for the public. So, the government sector, in fact, is also a very large and very important sector of the economy, which makes demand for final goods and services regularly. Okay. And this government's demand for final goods and services basically depends on the policy of the present government and socio-economic conditions of the economy. If the policy of the government is people's oriented, then there will be larger government's demand and vice versa. Similarly, if the socio-economic condition of the country, of the economy, is miserable, then the government will make higher demand for goods and services, because it will have to perform a lot of works in the society. Particularly in a democratic country like India, the responsibility of the democratically elected government happens to be very high, and the government has to make arrangement and provisions for all-round progress and development of the society. So, the socio-economic condition and policy of the prevailing government determine the level of government's demand. You know, students, this government's demand for final goods and services is also measured in terms of the expenditure made by the government on final goods and services. That is called the government's final consumption expenditure, and it is also a very important component of aggregate demand. Okay, students, the last major component of aggregate demand is net export demand. This demand refers to the demand for final goods and services made by the external sector, rest of the world sector or foreign sector. Okay. And this demand also depends on several factors, but primarily on rate of exchange, on terms and trade, terms and conditions of trade, on import and export policy of the concerned governments of the concerned countries. It depends on tariff policy of the government, and so many factors it depends. Okay. And whatever expenditure is made by the foreign sector on final goods and services, that is called net export demand, expressed as X minus M, in which X denotes export and M denotes import. Okay, students. So, these are the four major components of aggregate demand, which are called household consumption demand, investment demand, government's demand, and net export demand. In short, you can say AD is equal to C plus I plus G plus X minus M, in which C denotes household consumption demand, I denotes investment demand, G denotes government's demand, and X minus M denotes net export demand. Okay, students, but for easy understanding of the theory, and since the net export demand and government's demand are very smaller part of GDP, therefore Keynes has considered only the household consumption demand and investment demand as the major components of aggregate demand. So we can say that AD is equal to C plus I only. Okay. So students, in today's session, I have discussed about the meaning and components of aggregate demand. I will also discuss in detail all these in online class. But before that, better you go through this topic very carefully and sincerely from your textbook. And if have any confusion, then have a conversation with me. Thank you very much.